All right, let's check this out right here. Let's update this particular page right here. We want to touch on some of the questions that have come in and some of the comments at our www.theyoutubes.com and on the Ethiopian World Net or the Ilnet, the Ethiopian World Net on our channel on the YouTubes. Now you see right here, here's the front page. I think we're trying to refresh it, update it, actually. But while we remain waiting, we've got a couple of windows going on, a couple of things going on. This is our 2012, that we say 2012 as predicted by a slave master, Willie Lynch, Let's Make a Slave, in that 300 years after 1712, when Willie Lynch was reported, and according to the evidence, because some dispute the whole Let's Make a Slave, but they haven't presented any documentation or evidence that counters that the information is accurate and that that particular document is historical. So there's been many who have sought to dismiss or deny the truth of Let's Make a Slave. But what's very interesting is that 300 years, and in the beginning of that particular speech by Willie Lynch, he basically says that this is in the 1712th year of our Lord. And the editor also seems to emphasize that particular matter. As we say, the history of that document seems to be connected with Frederick Douglass. And the version that we were able to get was dated from 1970. It was dated from 1970. So this information was known and available back in the 70s. And then we in 1996 would take the document, retypeset it, scanned it, and then typeset it, and then put it out under the Ethiopian Brotherhood of the Nazarene, or under the Ibn particular order. Now, we got one particular comment about the video from Amari Mocha, and Amari Mocha basically had said, I've never seen the brother that fired up, more fire, well, give thanks. Our response that, scripturally speaking, was from this area of Jeremiah, and it seems as though the Holy Spirit has been pointing to Jeremiah the prophet. There's a lot of prophetic words in the book of Jeremiah that when we look at the black people's situation in the Americas, in particular in this North country, there's much that is in the prophecy Tinbiter Arimius, or the prophecy of Jeremiah, that actually fits, especially since this is also the year in which the MLK monument has gone up in D.C., and people are looking at the 40 years, what has changed. Now we're on the verge of having potentially two types of black men. You understand? Two black men, speaking of President Barack Obama and the Republican frontrunner, Herman Cain. So this is very interesting. But now the verse that we had quoted in response to the fire comment was from Yahweh's word, and here it says in Jeremiah 23 and 29, it says, is not my word like as a fire, saith the Lord, saith Yod-Heh-Wah-Heh, and like a hammer that breaketh the rock in pieces. Now, it's important to note what it says about hammer right there, because hammer makes the connection with Maccabees. So there's a significant Maccabees connection that breaketh the rock into pieces. And then afterward, you can see there's a particular judgment against prophets, against those who are considered by the people to be prophets or to be spokesmen for God. And so we have to look at our Negro so-called or black spokesmen, those who have claimed to be spokesmen for God, including and especially MLK, Martin Luther King Jr. Now, I've come some way of growth myself in what first was revealed or receivable to me from God's word concerning MLK. And if you look over some of the older videos and some of the later videos and audios where we've touched on the subject matter of civil rights or 40 years ago or Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., one can see some would say that that is a growth. Some might say it's a refinement and so forth and so on. But it's not because we're trying to please popular opinion or please people, because some people don't, they know what this truth is. And the references in particular in Jeremiah chapter 23 are quite relevant, especially with black people's experience in the Americas and the Caribbean. Now we're going to one of our favorite online sites, and this is the Blue Letter Bible. And here's the King James Version, which is the first basic version that we touch on. And here, this is Jeremiah chapter 23, and you can see that it begins off in verse 1 where it says, "Woe to the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord." That saith the Lord. It says, "Therefore thus saith the Lord God of Israel, against the pastors," that's the religious people. We can say that's against the so-called black clergy or the Negro clergy in reference to us as the once lost but now found sheep of the house of Israel. It says, or the ethnic Jews. It says, "Therefore, thus saith the Lord God of Israel against the pastors that feed," the ones who spiritually feed we the black people, "feed my people, feed Jah's people, God's people. Ye have scattered my flock and driven them away, and have not visited them. Behold, I will visit upon you the evil of your doings, saith the Lord." Now this is particularly, we find that this particular area of scripture is particularly interesting. And we call this the Civil Rights 40 Years Ago chapter. This is the Civil Rights 40 Years Ago chapter. Now, one first of all needs to be able to admit and recognize, well, who we are as the once lost but now found Beit Israel, in order to properly understand this and to put it into its proper context. Now, let us go to our channel, the YouTube channel right here. Let's go to YouTube's channel, and it's loading in right now, and here we are. Now, we've just uploaded a particular video, and we see that the information for the video, some online study materials, has not refreshed or has not loaded in. Now, these are some of the videos that we have loaded up there concerning the 2012, and as well as the Ethiopian Holocaust, and the fact that slavery was an anti-Semitic act against the true Jews or the Beit Israel, the lost sheep, who we are. Now here, here's our channel comments, and this is what we wanted to get into right here, some of the channel comments. And there's one particular channel comment in particular that we wanted to address, and this was 2 days ago, roughly 2 days ago, and this is Music Cattings, who said, "Greetings, brothers and sisters, Wyndham Yadin. My research shows that Thutmose the Third, as the Pharaoh who knew not Joseph, the grandfather of Moses, as he reigned for 55 years. This would make sense considering Moses was in Ethiopia for 40 years and came back after his death. He has found out that Amenhotep II was the Pharaoh of the Exodus, as he was not able to carry out extensive military operations." That is very right and exact. This is how we are able to localize the time period of the real exodus of our ancestors to this particular time period because of the military operation. So, in other words, when we study this history, we study it more than just so-called religious or in a misguided spiritual sense, because a lot of people are spiritual, but they're not into the messianic consciousness or the Moshiach consciousness, which is known as Christ consciousness. So they're spiritual, but they're dealing with spiritual evil and wickedness, because that's what Jeremiah basically says, that woe to those pastors You understand? To those pastors that scatter the flock because they're not dealing with the, they're dealing with a PC message, politically correct message. And even MLK, up until the period of his death or towards the later period of his death, we can see that change also going on in MLK. This is why I say that my view somewhat has been refined concerning Dr. Martin Luther King, even though he was the one that helped to put out that dream thing that Jeremiah chapter 23 basically condemns. Now, we're 40 years later. We're 40 years out from MLK. And this is why we want to get to this particular comment right here from our brother Music Cattings that was posted up there about two days ago. And to go on with his comment, where he's saying that he found out that Amenhotep II was the foul of the Exodus, as he was not able to carry out extensive military operations, recovering from the loss at the Red Sea. And the loss, you probably already read this, the loss was the military loss. In other words, that it was Pharaoh's troops that sunk. The Pharaoh lost that army. Now, what's significant about this, when we put these two things together, because what I'm putting together is this cusp of a Willie Lynch prediction or prophecy or 2012, the futures, the stocks and bonds future that Willie Lynch forecasted for this experiment in white supremacy and racism that we call America, that we call this particular land and what we're in right now, and everything that we're witnessing with Occupy Wall Street and all the type of protests and what's going on around the world and how this is catching a fire with the world, whether everyone recognizes the full details or not. As they say, the devil's in the details or the deception is in the details. When we learn the details of the story, then we'll recognize how we've been fooled popularly, you understand, or by some say the media or the false pastors, which is talking about that old Negro church or that previous Negro church or the Negro church over the past 40 years. They bear a crushing and awesome responsibility for the current state or status of the black community. So it's very important for them to own up and for us to make them accountable, speaking about the so-called black church. You understand? A lot of them now using this Dr. King memorial to kind of take attention off of the fact that if we study King carefully, King seems to have been maturing and seeing the more global picture that ones like Malcolm X and the Honorable Elijah Muhammad also saw. But let's just go through this right here, your comment, my brother. Give thanks. Exodus 12 and 29 explains the reason for Thutmose IV not being the legitimate son, as his firstborn was killed at a young age. Now, that part there is interesting concerning Thutmose IV, because we notice that there was a son before Amenhotep II, that they found his remains and everything. They said that he died as a young man, and there was no obvious kind of like wounds on him, like some pharaohs or some mummies, they find that the people had suffered some brutal attack, you know, and they were killed or they were murdered or something like that. But there's no obvious signs on this particular one, who was it was actually the firstborn of Thutmose the Third. Now, Thutmose the Third is a very, very important pharaoh, because they call him the so-called Napoleon or the Alexander of Egypt, but actually Alexander and Napoleon should be called the Thutmoses of Greece and of France. It's actually the other way around, but that also shows some of their, you know, their racism. You understand? And that's what showed that Thutmose and the rest of them were not of their ethnic stock, because if they were, they would give him the proper credit and the proper order. So we begin to see these things. That's why we put up the videos with the so-called, restored bust of Thutmose III. And when you see the more original bust, you understand, and the original iconography and the imagery of the first one, the original one, the real one, or the black one, and then the one that they've done later on, how they have sought to change some of these features. But remember this, even though ones might say some of our, because we're studying this, and so some things might be inaccurate based on the secondhand information that we're getting. We, as a people, have not had the opportunity to study the art and fact for ourselves. So this is why, based on the information, we say yes, based on what's available and what we can verify from two or three witnesses, you understand, from two or three data sources that are reliable, you understand, based on what we can assess from this point of view. So we have to also kind of not put a disclaimer there, but note that, you know, in a lot of the artifacts and archaeology, how many of us have had an opportunity to study this for ourselves firsthand? So we are studying based on other authors and authorities. So we still have to caution that this particular point of view about Thutmose the Third and what you said right here is very accurate, as you probably can see for yourself in your studies, because there's a lot of different sources as you really study these issues that provide additional evidence that corroborates and backs up the basic point of view or the basic conclusions that we are making or that you may be making and that various ones are making. So that's just a point right there. Now, there's a couple of other comments here because we decided maybe we'll just put these two things together. Let's see if we can get to some of the other comments. So give thanks, Music Catchings. That is very accurate. You understand, based on the same sources that we have looked at. And even though we may find one source that seems to say what we are inclined to accept or want to accept as true, we ourselves do not just go off of that. We'll say, well, this is from this one source, and we might not have found any other additional information, because we know that if we go all so-called gung-ho on that, and just because it's what we so-called want to see or are inclined to see, it might not be that accurate as more information comes out, and y'all willing, as we get to study these things for ourselves. Now, S.J. Williams, 1111, 2 days ago said, Shabbat Shalom. Hope the family is having a blessed Sabbath. Give thanks, my brother, and give thanks, fam. Yes, we can say amen, amen, and I hope that the I has also been having a good fall festival, or the, what's called the ingathering Yom Kippur Sukkot season. This is a very important season. We're about to now on what they call the Simchat Torah. And around that particular holy day, we're about to begin off again with the, we're going to end with the last portion, the last reading. I think one of the brothers probably have went ahead and started to read further on. Let's see, Jungle Book 20, please read if possible. Bless love, Ras Iadonis, and bless love to you, brother and sister, uses the online name Jungle Book, since we don't know the eye's exact name. But anyway, it says, in response to your Osar video, when talking about Moses and critics who are on either side of the Bible versus ancient Kemet argument, have you ever come across info that relates popular characters in the four books of Moses to historical pharaohs? In the documentary Ring of Power, a five-hour-long documentary on YouTube, the narrator does so. If you get a chance to watch, I would appreciate your opinion on such information. Please disregard the whitewash visuals that they provide. Thanks, brother. Give thanks for that comment, the whole comment, but especially what you said at the latter point of the comment, that we have to be able to be mature enough to watch these videos and be able to recognize that they are, you know, some of it's historically accurate but visually deceptive. You know, and then we have to check out the history, because little things probably creeping in historically, if they could do what they could do visually, knowing that these ones are historical. Yes, we have. And that video is very, very interesting. We've been wanting to actually go through a commentary and analysis of that particular video, the video you mentioned, Ring of Power. So there's more to come on that. Give thanks for your comment as well. And yes, we have, and still looking at it as the Bible versus ancient Kemet, what we found to be a witness to the truth and be more embeddable with the true reality is that it's both the Bible and ancient Kemet. It's really their arguments, or the arguments that have been put out there by others. Remember, black people were prevented from reading and writing and having access to the knowledge or information in slave master society, and even today for a large part. So there is a lot that we need to get to, first of all, just become familiarized with. So some of this information, we don't have to have a conclusion about this information because it can be a research or work in progress. So about some of these things that they put out, we don't have to just rush to a conclusion. We can accept the information, say, you know, the jury is still out, and to do more study on it. Remember the Bible principle, two or three witnesses is used to judge any matter. If you could get two or three witnesses, that means certain data file or information as well. So your comment, Jungle Book 20, I connect that with Music Cadding's comment that deals like ancient Egypt and the Bible, and there's more to come, y'all willing, on that. So give thanks, and we're going to touch on that again, y'all willing. Now, we're going to move on to the next brother or sister, Mansa. Kemwer, Senbet Salam, LOJS, and family, and Senbet Salam, Shalom Rastafari to you, Mansa Kemwer, as well. Next comment, about 2 days ago, these are comments from 2 days ago, peaceful Sabbath, Salam, self, the soul, Furik, give thanks for that. Now, Shabbat Shalom to you as well, and Shabbat Shalom to all the brothers and the sisters and the mothers. Iconic. Music, your comment, we want to get into probably at in the next part of this as well, because a few comments there, and we're going to the 2-2 time. This is about 22 minutes, you understand, Aleph to Tav, and we're going to sum it up around there and then come for the next one, because it's another area of study that we want to touch on. So stay tuned for that as well. So Shalom Ras Teferi.